I'm going to be talking to you guys about my disability, and I'm going to be talking to you guys about my osteogenesis imperfecta. If you did not know, that is what I have. So, yeah. So, I'm going to be talking to you guys about how it affects me personally. Now, if you want to know more about the overall disease, because it does affect everybody very, very differently, I'm going to have links down below where you guys can go read about it on the website. And I'm pretty sure there's some other things that I have that goes along with it that I will forget to mention in this video that you guys can read about as well. So, yeah, let's just get right on into it. Alright, so if you guys catch me glancing down, I made myself a little cheat sheet so that way I wouldn't forget anything. So, yeah, I'm going to be referring to that cheat sheet a lot throughout this video, and I'm really sorry, but I just have a lot of ground to cover, so, yeah. Okay, so first off, let's just start out with what osteogenesis imperfecta is, so that way you'll understand that a little bit better. So basically what osteogenesis imperfecta is, it is a brittle bone disease. That's also another term that doctors and stuff use for it. But basically what it is a generic disorder, or sometimes a generic mistake can just happen. That's actually what happened with me. Neither one of my parents had it, nor their families had it, so, I just popped up. Like, I was just a random gene that popped up, and that's just the way that God chose to make me. So, yeah, and, but basically what it means is, like, my bones break very, very easily. They pretty much break like glass or chalk. I have to be super careful about, like, lifting heavy things and just doing everyday tasks in general. Like, I have to be kind of, like, careful about how I do them. So, yeah. There are 8 known types now of osteogenesis imperfecta. Actually, I'm going to just call it by its abbreviation, which is OI, throughout the rest of this video, because that's just a long word to say. But anyway, there is now 8 known types of OI, and I don't really know about 4 of them. The only 4 that I know about is the 4 that was around when I was born. So type 1, and what's weird about osteogenesis imperfecta is it doesn't go, the severity of it doesn't go by numbers like most disorders and diseases and things usually do. The severity of it doesn't go by numbers, which is really strange. But anyway, so type 1 is like the least severe possible, and it's actually, I'm pretty sure a lot of times it is sometimes like the most common form. There's a lot of people around my town that live near me that like know of type 1 and like have, there's some people that live close by to where I live that have type 1 and stuff. But anyway, what type 1 is basically, it's really not that severe. You wouldn't know that they had type 1 unless you asked them. Like, if you just straight up asked them if they had OI, you wouldn't know, because they literally look like your average Joe. Like, they are tall, they don't have as many breaks, they're not as hospitalized as often with stuff, so you really wouldn't know that they had it unless you asked them. Type 2, it is the, I'm pretty sure it is like the most severe form, because most people who are born with type 2 usually die shortly after birth. And if they don't die shortly after birth, they usually die like a year or two after they're born, because their bodies are so weak and frail. They're more susceptible to fractures, and like their lungs and just different things, they don't develop. So they just, unfortunately, they just pass away. Most of them do by the time they're babies or like they're a year or two old. So yeah. And then type 3, it is a shorter stature version, and most people who are in type 3 are wheelchair bound, although I do know some people who have type 3 and they use walkers and stuff to get around. But basically, type 3, they do have a lot of fractures, and they but that, like, they have a longer life expectancy than type 2. They don't break as more often as a type 2 does. And then type 4 is, I think, I'm not 100% positive, but I think they're wheelchair bound and they're short, but they don't have as many breaks as a type 3. So when I was born, I was diagnosed shortly after I was born. They pretty much noticed, like my mom said, they pretty much noticed, like after I was born, that something wasn't right. They just didn't know what. Because my torso was really short, my head was kind of big, my arms and my legs were short and bowed. And they just, I don't really know how to explain it, but they just kind of knew something wasn't right because I was screaming. I wasn't crying, like I was just straight up screaming. So basically, they discovered that I had 32 broken bones, and that's how I was diagnosed with OI. And then when I was a few weeks old, I know I went to Ohio. I don't know what part of Ohio I went to, but I went to Ohio and I got a skin biopsy done, and then they determined what type I had. And when that test result came back, it came back very confusing because I had type 2, type 3. I don't really know what makes me a type 2 and what makes me a type 3. They couldn't really explain it. That's really all I know is I have type 2, type 3. Yeah. So that is very strange. Yeah. I have had over 100 breaks in my whole entire life. How many people that are 22 can say that? Not many, but I can. I do have like a lot of the health problems that kind of like go along with OI. I have like respiratory problems. I have some stomach issues. I take 5 medicines a day, but I'm just not gonna get into all of that in this video because that would just be kind of like personal and weird. But yeah. So I'm trying to think, is there anything else that I wanted to discuss with you guys? Oh, I did start a treatment when I was younger. It's called, I always pronounce this really wrong. It's called Permethrinate. I'll have the word somewhere in here because I'm pretty sure I just butchered that. But basically what it is it's just a treatment that I get every 4 months, and it helps strengthen my bones. I've been getting that since I was about 10 or 11, I think. And basically what it just helps strengthen my bones, and it helps me have fewer fractures. Now, please do not leave me any comments down below saying how like I need to take protein supplements, or I need to drink or eat cheese or drink milk or anything like that, because my body doesn't have problems with protein, and it doesn't have problems breaking down calcium. It just has a problem with collagen. Osteogenesis imperfecta is a collagen disorder. So what I'm gonna actually do for you guys is I'm gonna have links down in the description below where you guys can go and read about all the osteogenesis imperfecta. You might also find a surprise video link down below as well. And if you would, I would really appreciate it if you clicked that surprise video link down below, because you might see a younger version of someone in front of you, and you might have a better understanding of what osteogenesis imperfecta is. So with that being said, I am just going to end off this video right now. Alright, you guys, so thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope this really was not that too confusing for you guys, and if it was, I'm really sorry. But I'm going to be doing a Q&A video all about my bone disease, so that way you guys can get to know more about me and more about my disease if you want to. So you guys can ask me anything that you want to. I'll answer any questions, because my motto is in life, you don't know unless you ask. So yeah, so I'm going to do that very, very soon for you guys. So be sure to follow me on my Twitter and my Instagram, because that's where I'm going to be taking questions from. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video very, very soon. Bye guys, thanks for watching.